What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Frankie Hardwork with another video. Now, in this video, it's about the Nipsey Hussle. It's a memorial. I didn't watch pretty much all of it. I watched some of it. And I'm catching a lot of it on YouTube. But I was listening to his brother Black Sam. You know, that was the sad part, man, because I got brothers. You know what I'm saying? So I was listening to him, and you know. And I felt for him, man. I really did, man. You know what I'm saying? I really did. But some of the things that he was saying in his speech, you know, was kind of stood out to me. You know, it was a couple of things he said in the speech, you know. And I'm not the player, you know. It's going to be a nice few minutes or whatever, but you should listen to it, man. It's a good speech. I want you to just hear a couple of parts. I'm gonna come back and speak on it, you know, the parts that I felt like, you know, need to be spoken about.
Dreams, you know, he built something and people are coming, paying homage like a Mecca. They coming from all over the world, all over the country. And, you know, it's something so special. And, you know, I was talking to him and we were so heartbroken that Fats wasn't around to see the album come out. So I just couldn't understand how, after all this, bro, go out like this, man. It just really don't make sense. Really don't make sense. And, you know, changed everything I thought I understood. You know, it gotta be something past this, man, for bro to go out like that. You know, last thing I'm gonna say is, you know, I'm proud of bro. You know, he always looked out and always wanted other people to go. You know, it wasn't just about him getting there. You know, he'd been fly since a young age. You know, it wasn't about that. It was about bringing it back and inspiring. Building, and he had so many plans, and he had so many people that he wanted to involve in his plans, and it was getting there. You know, we bought the lot, man, but I don't know how we did it. You know, and that was a big thing for bro, man, because he used to sell CDs out the trunk. You know, he used to be in that parking lot. And they used to try to kick him out of the lot. And y'all know what we went through with the police in that lot. And I don't know if anybody knows, we had got a 30-day notice. And they was kicking us out of all the businesses that we owned in the lot. And the owner was like, man, I'm so sorry. The district attorney and the police, they put pressure on us. They said we could lose this property if we don't kick you guys out the lot. I remember this used to be a vacant lot, and people used to be scared to rent the lot. You guys came here, you changed it. People are pulling up. Every lot is rented. And at this point, if you guys still are interested in buying the lot, you know, rather than kick you guys out, we're willing to sell it to you. We shook hands and said we do want to buy the lot. We didn't know how we was going to do it, honestly. And Nip went on a scramble. I went on a scramble. Tapped in with JP, the whole team. And I honestly don't know how we did it. But we was able to close and get the lot. And Nip was so proud of that and so happy of that accomplishment. You know, I don't drink, man, but I went ahead and took a shot with bro for that, man, you know. That and when the album came out, just even the Victory Lap album coming out, man, Nip said he was going to do it. And that was so important for his debut album to finally really come out. And, you know, I'm just so happy that the album was able to come out and he was able to do what he said he was going to do, you know. a lot of people thought coming up and when he first got signed, he was going to get some money and leave. You know, like he said, they didn't have a fucking clue. You know what I mean? They had no clue of what he really was going to do. And, come on. Yeah, I want everybody to know, man. Put his heart and soul on Crenshaw and Slauson. And, he's a talker, you know. We gotta go. We don't know if we're gonna go at 80, 60, 30, or 20. But the one thing is to make sure when you go the right way. You stand up for what you believe in. You put your money where your mouth is. Never fold. Never let the pressure sway you from doing what you want to do. Never let anything in politics stop you from coming around and staying around. And I hope everybody knows that that's what Bro did. Bro stayed and he died on Crenshaw and Slauson. Everybody who showed love, even the ones who didn't, they've had nothing but love, nothing but love and respect and humbleness. And that's what I want to leave, man. I love him. And I hope I didn't leave anything out, man.
Yeah, it's your boy. I'm back, man. But once again, rest in peace of Nipsey Hussle, man. Like, you know, I feel for his bro, man. Real talk, man. Honestly, though. But he was saying a lot of things, you know, towards the end of that speech. You know, the speech was a good speech. You know, he was talking about his brother and, you know, what they went through and things of that nature. But I specifically played towards the end part for a reason, because towards the end, he was dropping some extra jewels, you know, some bonus jewels, you know. And, you know, a couple parts that stood out to me was the fact that he, you know, how he was talking about the cops harassed him, you know, how they harassed him all the time. You know, and that's crazy. Then another part that stood out to me was the fact that how it got that serious where district attorney and everything like that forced them to get out. But they ended up buying it. So that kind of stood out to me. But you know what else stood out to me towards the end? Because it was like, I'm not going to say, you know, he was like putting clues or whatever out there. Not at all. But it was like, when he start bringing, like, never let politics and anything make you leave the hood. You understand? And that's one thing that Nipsey was real serious about. He did not want to leave his hood. He went around telling everybody, keep your property, don't sell, build. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, they don't want people like that around. They don't want people like that around. You see what I'm saying? So, you know, I just want to know how you felt about towards the end, you know what I mean, of that, of Black Sam speech. You know, it was powerful. It really was. It really was powerful. And if you just listen, you'll see. It was like he was really talking. He was talking some shit, you know. He was deep. But I hurt for that brother, man. I hurt for him. Honestly, though. But I just got to say this, man, like, they want us to leave our hood, y'all. I want to make a video on this, too. But they want us to leave our hood. They want us to get up and go. Because if you don't notice what's going on now, right? It's a lot of gentrification going on. Right? We leave our hood trying to chase them and be around them. What they do? They come back to the hood and buy it up. Move in there. See what I'm saying? And that was the thing about Nipsey Hussle. He wanted to keep the hood because he knew what it was. Because you know you've been hearing a lot of trend lately since Nipsey Hussle died that, you know, get your money and get out. Listen, I ain't going to go deeper to it in this video, but nah, you can't abandon your own people like that, man. Yeah, I know what some people might say, it'd be your own people that get you. True, it is what it is. But come on, we can't take the bad seeds and just make everybody pay, you know? But I ain't gonna go no further into it. I'm gonna make another video about this we shouldn't leave the hood and why I feel that way. But I'm going to let y'all go, man. Y'all be good. It's your boy, Frankie Hard Work. I need you to like, comment, subscribe, man. Y'all be good, man.